Mr. Taru, in this example video, we're going to be taking a look at two vectors which are being stated as being perpendicular or orthogonal. It would still be able to work out the same, and use that fact to find some unknown components of two vectors. In the description, you're going to find a timestamp to jump ahead straight to the work of this product, of this example. If you don't need the review that I'm going to do to lead you into this, maybe you're just doing this as a review and not as a lesson. And you'll also find a link to my playlist of all the videos I've done involving vectors so far. So let's go ahead and get started. We have vector A has the components of h negative 3 and 1, and vector B is equal to h plus 1, h and negative 15. If you do not recognize this notation, it's just the way that my textbook is writing these vectors in component form. You may see this as vector A is equal to h negative 3 and 1, or that A is equal to h times vector I minus 3 times vector j plus 1 times vector k, where I, j, and k are those component vectors in the direction of the x, y, and z or z axis. Okay, so also given the fact that h is an element of all real numbers, how are we going to solve for these unknowns? We're going to have to recall a fact that there's something special about vectors which are perpendicular and orthogonal when you're analyzing them together. It's that their dot product, picture in picture, that the dot product, inner product, or the scalar product is equal to zero. Now, why is that? Well, there's two definitions of dot product, and I think the first one here will jog your memory or help you understand this. The dot product of two vectors is equal to the magnitude of vector A times the magnitude of vector B times the cosine of theta. And if your two vectors are perpendicular or orthogonal, meaning that there's basically 90 degrees, or we're working in radians, pi over 2 radians, between those two vectors, well, the cosine of pi over 2 is equal to 0. And since the dot product of two vectors is basically the product of three numerical values, the magnitude of each vector and the cosine of the angle between those two vectors, well, then the dot product is equal to 0. And we, you know, don't really directly know the magnitude of each of these vectors, nor would it be very easy with these unknowns to find the angle between these two vectors. Well, actually, we technically know it. It's pi over 2 radians. But we're going to be using this definition here. The dot product of two vectors A and B is equal to the product of the horizontal components plus the product of the vertical components plus, well, these are the formulas if you're in 2 space, but our problem is in 3 space with movements along the x, y, and z axis. So all I have to do to adjust these two-dimensional definitions to work here is add in that the magnitude, if you're finding that, is the horizontal component squared, the magnitude, plus the vertical component squared, or the movement along the, movement along the x-axis, basically y-axis, and the component along the z-axis squared. And then the dot product is, making a little extra room here, the product of the horizontal components, or those components along the x-axis, plus the product of the components along the y-axis, plus the components along the z-axis. In 3 space, we don't really want to say horizontal and vertical component, because it's common that your, when you look at your vectors in 3 space, x, y, and z-axis. Okay, so that's a review of all the concepts of what's going on here. Let's get to work. So now that we have our sort of fundamentals reviewed, if we needed it, let's go ahead and get to the problem. We are told again that these vectors are perpendicular. So now we completely understand that, hopefully, that the dot product has to be equal to zero if that is the case. So vector A dotted with vector B, well, that's going to be the result of taking the components along the x-axis and multiplying them together, plus the components along the y-axis and multiplying those together, plus the components along the z-axis, multiply those together, And recall, again, or just know the fact that that dot product has to be equal to zero if these vectors are stated to be perpendicular. So we have h squared plus h minus 3h minus 15. That again needs to be equal to zero. Combine like terms, h squared minus 2h minus 15 is equal to zero. This is a factorable quadratic. Factors of negative 15 that add to negative 2 are negative 5, so h minus 5, and positive 3, so h plus 3 is equal to 0, and that's going to give us our final possible values of h to be either 5 or h can be equal to negative 3. I missed a true. Bam! Go do your homework.